Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain details related to reports and dashboards. Those are available in Salesforce. If you want to watch more videos related to reports and dashboard, like how to create reports and dashboard and how we can use them on record pages, so you can find the link of playlist in the description of this video. Also, that link is available at the end of this video, right? So go to that playlist, so you will find various videos related to reports and dashboard. So watch all the videos so that you can learn everything about reports and dashboards. So now I'm going to start my explanation. So along with explanation, I will be giving some demonstration as well, like how you can open the report tab and how you can open dashboards. So first, let's understand what is a report. So report is a list of records related to objects that meet the criteria defined, right? So basically, report contains a list of records related to a particular object where certain criteria which is defined that meets. Then if we see the second point, let me take a pointer. So if we see the second point, so here you can see it is mentioned one can filter, group, and do maps on reports. So you can do these three things. You can filter the report, you can group the report, and you can do some maps on report. Then third point says one can display reports graphically through charts. So you can apply charts as well after creating the reports. Then every report is stored in a folder. So whenever you create a report, you can create separate folders for reports, or you can put more than one reports in a single folder as well. The next point says reports folders determines how one can access reports to view, edit, or manage. So these are three permissions which you can provide to different users, like they can view or they can edit or they can manage your reports which are available in the report folders, right? So as I already told you, I have created a playlist related to reports and dashboard. So one video is available there which will be demonstrating you these sharing things, like how view, edit, and manage sharing work in case of report folders. So you can watch that video. Then last point is report folders can be public, hidden, or shared, right? So this is a simple screenshot of the report that I created in my org. So let me take you to the org. So if you open your org, so there you will find two tabs, reports and dashboard. If those tabs are not available in your app, so you can click on this app launcher, and here you can search for report. So here you can see reports tab is available, and if you type dashboard, so that will be available. So here it is, right? So if it is available on the top, you can click on it and it will be opened. Otherwise, you can click on app launcher and search and click on that link. Then here you can see two reports are available, and at left hand side, reports options are available: created by me, private report, public report, all reports. Then you can see folder options are available. So if you click on all folders, so all the folders will be displayed. If you click on all reports will be displayed. So this way, these reports are available in the org. And if you click on any report, so its preview will be displayed. So this way it will show you the data. And I also added a chart on this report, so it is displaying that as well. And if you click on this edit button, so it will be opening report builder in edit mode. So I'm not covering this scenario in this video. So I will be demonstrating how we can create different kind of reports in my another video. So follow this playlist related to reports and dashboard. So I demonstrated this so that you can have a visualization, like how we open reports and how we can visualize that thing. Now, if I move forward, so here you can see report folders option is available. So as every report is stored in a folder, so report folders determines how one can access reports to view, edit, and manage. So these are three sharing sharing setting. So these are associated with the folders. So if you have a particular sharing setting, like you have view permission or you have edit permission or you have manage permission, so then only you can control your reports. Those are available in the report folder, otherwise not. Then report folders can be public, hidden or shared, and we can control access of contents of the folder based on roles, permission, public groups, territories and license types, right? So this sharing thing I will be demonstrating in my another video, so you can follow this playlist. So in this video we are only discussing the introductory part of reports and dashboard. So now it's time to understand what is dashboard. So a dashboard is a visual display of key metrics and trends for records in your org. Then as per second point, source of dashboard is reports. So if you have created any report and you want it to display visually, then you can put your multiple reports together in a single dashboard, right? So there are two options. You can, first option is you can display your report individually, or if you have group of reports and you want to place them together on a report page or home page, so you can create a dashboard, put your reports together in a particular dashboard and place that dashboard on the page. Then third point says you can place one report in a multiple dashboards component on a single dashboard, right? So you can place your one report in multiple dashboard components. So it is also possible, like you have one report and you want to display it differently, like you want to display in form of pie chart, you want to display same report in form of bar chart. So that is also possible, right? So this thing you can do with the help of dashboard. Then last point is having multiple reports on a single dashboard page makes it a powerful visual display tool. So this I already explained you. So this is the snapshot or screenshot of dashboard. So here you can see this showing two reports. So right now, both the reports are different. So this first report is showing pie chart, second report is showing bar chart. But if you want to display two different charts for a single report or two different kind of things for a single report, then you can do that through dashboard. So now I'm taking you to the dashboard. So this is a tab for dashboard. And here is my dashboard that I created for this screenshot. In my later video, you will see how we can create dashboards. So this is for basic demonstration purpose. So here we have this dashboard. Only two components are available. You can add more components as well. So now moving forward. So next we have dashboard folders. So like reports, dashboard folders are stored, dashboards are stored in a folder as well. So dashboard folder controls who has access to its content, similar to reports. Second point is if one has access to folder, then only one can access its dashboard. So this is very important. And this also applies for reports. So if you have access to folders, then only you can access respective reports or dashboards. Then last point is, however, to view the dashboard components, one need access to underlying reports as well. So this is also important. So let's say if you have access to dashboard folder, but you don't have access to report folder, those are referenced in dashboards. Then you will be able to access the dashboard, but you will not be able to access the reports. Those are used inside that dashboard. So if you want to see reports as well as dashboards, so you need permission on both folders, reports as well as dashboard. So keep in mind that thing. Now, next is important about dashboards. So these are some important things that you need to understand. So each dashboard has a running user. So if you see the screenshot, so here you can see viewing as Sanjay Gupta. So this is the current logged in user through which it is executed or it is rendered. So each dashboard has a running user. So it can be current logged in user or it can be a specific user. So here in second point, you can see running users security settings determine which data to display in the dashboard. So this is very important. If the running user is a specific user, then all dashboard viewers sees data based on the security setting of that user, regardless of their own security setting, right? So this is very important. So whenever you have a specific user attached with a dashboard, then you will see data according to that user, not as per you. But if you want to view the data which belongs to you only, so dynamic dashboards are those for which running user is always logged in user. So mostly we pick this thing because we don't want to show those data which are not accessible by a particular user. So we can choose this thing. Here each user views the dashboard as per their own security, right? So we have these two things. So if I again take you to the dashboard, so here you can see this thing. So here it shows with which user you are viewing your dashboard. And right, so follow the reports and dashboard playlist so that you can see more videos related to reports and dashboard, like how we can create that, how we can create different kind of reports, how we can put them in dashboard, and how we can put reports and dashboard on report pages. So this is just introduction about reports and dashboards. So I hope you understood these basic things related to reports and dashboards in Salesforce. So keep watching more videos so that you can understand other things well. Thank you for watching this video.